Newspaper Boy and Origami Girl by Micheal Foreman. Every day, Joey the newspaper boy stood on the street corner trying to sell his newspapers and magazines. People pushed, rushed, and elbowed past him. He was often cold and hungry. At night, he slept on the newspapers he hadn't managed to sell. Late one cold autumn afternoon, a pack of young bullies grabbed Joey and stole what little money he had. Suddenly, to Joey's surprise, his newspaper bag flew into the air and the newspapers transformed into Origami Girl. She leaped in amongst the bullies and chased them off down the street, but they disappeared into the dark alleyways of the city.
"Oh no," Joey cried. "They've got my money. And who are you anyway?"
"I'm Origami Girl," she said. "Don't worry, we'll find them and get your money back."
She quickly folded a pair of wings out of newspaper.
"Climb on to my back," she said.
Origami Girl spread her wings and they soared up high above the city. From here, they could look down into the alleyways and soon spotted the group of bullies as they ran through the streets, snatching first an old lady's bag and then a little boy's mobile phone. The bullies joined up with other gangs and they all headed into an old tumble-down building by the river. Origami Girl and Joey landed on the roof. The rooms below were crowded with bullies, burglars, robbers and rascals of all kinds. In the middle, a fat old man sat counting money and examining jewels through a big magnifying glass. Origami Girl crashed through the skylight onto the table and dived in amongst the crooks, somersaulting, spinning, backflipping, cartwheeling and knocking them over like Skittles. Meanwhile, Joey spotted the fat crook creeping out of the back door and down the steps to the river. He parachuted down, bagged him with his newspaper bag, and sat on his head until Origami Girl appeared, dragging a dustbin full of stolen goods. She stuffed the fat crook into the dustbin and then ripped a huge poster off a theater wall. Quickly, she folded it into the body of a beautiful origami swan and transformed herself into the neck and head. Together, they sailed with the fat crook and the dustbin down the river to the river police. The fat crook was arrested and people came to reclaim their stolen goods. During the excitement, no one apart from Joey noticed the origami swan unfold back into a bundle of newspapers and slip into Joey's newspaper bag. The next day, Joey's picture was on the front page of all the newspapers above the headline, "The Boy Who Bagged the Big Bad Boss." And as for Origami Girl, she was happy to be snug, back in Joey's newspaper bag, waiting for the next adventure.